Hey everyone, I wanted to make this quick video to show you how I record voiceover right onto the Premiere timeline, and it's really easy. I actually use this USB mic, so this USB mic is plugged in right to my computer and Premiere could actually recognize it as an external mic, and this is just under 50 bucks actually, and it's really good audio quality. I'll have a link in the description to this mic. So in Premiere, you gotta just turn on a couple of things and then you could basically press this microphone icon and record right onto any audio track, any voiceover that you want to, and it's super simple. But let me show you some of those settings in Premiere Pro. There are a couple of things in preferences and in the timeline that you gotta turn on before you could start doing that voiceover. So let's jump onto Premiere Pro and I'll show you how to turn those settings on right now. Okay, I've jumped into the Premiere timeline and I want to start recording voiceover right here onto this track. So I want to do it right here on track number one. So I make sure track number one is enabled. And this is the icon right here, voiceover record. So if I press that, I could start recording onto the timeline. But before we do that, we got to set up a couple of things. First of all, if you don't see this icon, just go ahead and right click or control click here and click voiceover setting right here. And these are the settings for the voiceover setting. So as you could see right now, I've chosen my mic, the Blue Snowball. Again, there's a link in the description if you want to check this out. And that's my input. And I could either do a pre-roll or post-roll. So I do that and it'll count me down. So if you want to cue for that too, you could do that. And that's basically all the settings you need here. There's one more place where you got to turn on a couple of settings. Let me show you that right now. If you don't see this voiceover record icon, the microphone right here, make sure you control click or right click right here and go to customize. And under customize, you could just go ahead and grab that and you could bring it down and let it go and it'll appear right here on your audio track. So if you don't see that, you could go ahead and bring it down from there and then press okay. And again, right now I don't see it again because I need to expand this to make sure it appears. So if you don't see it, that's a couple ways to get it to appear. So you want to go up here to preferences and we want to click on audio, and under the audio tab here in preferences on a PC, it's actually under file preferences. So under the audio tab here, you got to check this on mute input during timeline. Let me check it off just to show you what happens. So now on my timeline, let me press record and it will start counting me down. And right now, if I start recording, I start getting this strange feedback loop. So let me just press space bar to pause that. So I start recording it. Let me just play that. If I start recording, I start getting this strange feedback loop. So let me go ahead and delete that. And we'll go ahead and turn that on into our preferences, audio. And let's make sure mute input during timeline recording is turned on. Press OK. So again, on your timeline, press record. It'll count you down. So now it's actually recording right onto the timeline. And whatever track is selected, so if I press the voiceover record on this track, it would have started recording on this track. So let me pause that. So if I started pressing this one, and now I could start recording on track number two. So again, if I press spacebar when I'm done recording, it'll be on track number two. So you could just go ahead and line up your voiceover against your video if you like to and put it on different tracks based on what you need to do. I hope this video was helpful. Please give it a like and subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.